the best. Yes. Well, let's remember that this is Southern Connection of City 105 family. The reality of charity. And remember, this man and ours, we are linked up together as of today. So when anytime you see this band, anytime you see this band, City 105 Southern Connection family will support this man 150% anywhere they go. Love in the house. Good music, youths. Keep up the pan. We love this.
Repertoire, but the youth them, we like the music.
You see you?
You see you? You see you? You're gonna pass a hat around. You wanna pay for the hat. It's only half an hour. You want something again, so I put in $100. Right, so that's $200.
$300.
Alright, that's $300. We like the music, so we passing the hat around, ladies and gentlemen, those who are inside and outside. We have 100 inside again, that's 4. So that's 4. We go with anybody else in the house. At 50 and 20. The band playing nice, the youth step. We like how the band going. So the Southern Connection. Alright. The Southern Connection playing 100. The group itself. So that's 5. So we have 5 for this so far. And I pass it around with a hat. We love it. Nice. I would like the band to know we have something in plan for Independence Day. In organizing a breakfast. I was a whole day like. It is not official, but we're looking forward to official, alright. The president of the City 105 Southern Connection say it's official that we're having a breakfast line in Kokie at Simpson Brown Terrace at the CPO residence. It will be a holy line. I'll be looking forward to the band performing Independence Night. So, Mr. Jules, we will talk. Independence Night. We got next under tonight, 600 for the band. So put that in the calendar for Independence Night. Independence Day. Not yet. It looks like you have a performance at home. 2.
Oh my gosh. I was expecting the whole length.
From what time to what time? We give you an hour, sir. It's Independence Day. We have a breakfast line from 7 in the morning. So if you can come and give you an hour or 2 in the morning, and then here you go. Right, so
right,
we cooperate with you, anything we have in,
right,
we like to cooperate with right. You, your band.
Collect them 2-1 time.
In it.
Collect.
Right, and we will be promoting you on City 105. Live on the Vibe City 105. All the time. As they call me, I'm the original Iron Chef.
The man in the hat.
Yeah, he playing your
part. That was
the first
part. He was.
the reality of charity. Our group is charity-based organization. We do a lot of charity work. We just just under a year, the group is. We must say we have been doing some good work with people of 105 and the people of San Fernando. We have some...
Okay, pleasant day to you, ladies and gentlemen. What we are about all here is to let you all know of this charity organization called the Southern Connection Vibe City 105 Family. This organization, this charity organization, was formed due to our brother at the 105, at the Vibe City 105 station, disc jockey CG Selman, Mr. Derek Selman, who fell ill to kidney problems. Myself, Winwood Scipio, I was a member of the Trinidad and Tobago Fire Service. Also, disc jockey DJ Enchantment Songs. I met CG in my early days in life, in my 30s. CG was a member of the Coast Guard. And we met at the convention center doing lectures, demonstrations for the different services. So we knew one another for a while. So what happened is a lot of people started to do charity work in the Port of Spain area for CG. And I took it upon myself, having known the gentleman, I decided to meet and talk with people of the Southern District for us to get involved and do something for this said gentleman. So presently, the place we are at right now, at the Eat Royal, last year for my birthday, I decided to talk with Betty, who I invited at my home. And we sat down and talked and decided, yes, let's do something in the South and raise funds to assist this gentleman who is ill and he needs a lot of funding because, you know, the hospitals here is a problem. So he went private at the St. Clair Medical Center, where he's getting treatment. So we decided to raise funds to assist because the bills are very high. So we started at November last year, and we had a barbecue. The barbecue was a success. So we decided, hey, let's don't end this, let's continue. Let's continue. And we don't have to just do it for Mr. Derek Selman, we can do it for others. We can do it for others. Others who in need, who may be sick and doesn't have the cash, the finance to see about the ailments. A lot of us people in this country, we die because we don't have funding, right? So we decide to continue to raise funds to assist those in need. So presently there are other people also who we are trying to assist. Maybe they're home and they can't afford it. We are assisting. So this is what the Southern Connections is all about. Right? But we call ourselves Southern Connection Vibe City 105 Family because people was always calling for a family from the radio station. And since we did that, we got people from Point, San Fernando, Sandy Grande, Indian Walk, all over, is willing to come together with us and do are good. We need more people like this. Charity goes a long way. When you do good, good always follow you. If you do bad, you're going to catch your bam bam. So please, people, it's time we open our eyes, wake up. I don't want a song racial or anything, right? We are not about black or white. We are about people. People, it's time to wake up and let's love one another in this country. Let's get together, do things for each other from the heart. Not for the dollar, but from the heart. And we will be blessed in the long run. So this is what it's all about. Thank you. And looking forward to each and everyone's support. You don't have to just support me, but just look out. You have a neighbor. Somebody might be ill. Right? You want to get in contact with me? 767-2528. 767-2528. Call me. The Southern Connection will be willing to come out and assist in any way possible. Thank you.
Everybody's support. Most and foremost, I want to thank the UN Southlanders Steel Orchestra for giving us the service this evening. Yay! And we want to thank you all very much for supporting us. We look forward to your support in the near future, as of today. And everybody know it's a worthy cause. We want to thank the Southern Connection. We have Belinda, Daniel, Enchantment, Mango, Susan, Auntie Betty. And we want to welcome all to Eat Royal, Michelle, and the rest of the crew, all the kids, everybody. Thanks for your support. And at this point in time, we made a contribution to the band that they would give us a little more time. So we want to thank you very, very much for being here for us. And we want to thank you all again and again and again. And in the near future, we hope to have you all play again. Thank you very, very much. Go!
What is the interview at?
And at the same time, the band will be having a barbecue on Saturday at Sion's Bar. And I'm looking forward to supporting the band again. So, Mr. Jules, on behalf of the Southern Connection, and the Eat Royal crew, thanks very much.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
We appreciate everything that you all did for us today. So, thanks again.
Here we go.
Thanks once again.
Yeah. Woo! Looking good.
Thank you all.
Yeah.
Thanks.
My name is Anjali Jules. I'm currently a student at the University of the West Indies. I'm studying a bachelor's degree in political science with a minor in international relations. I attended St. Gabriel's Girls RC as my primary school and Debe High Secondary as my high school. I've been playing pan since the age of 9 with the Gabrielites, which was a band in St. Gabriel's Girls RC. And from then, I progressed into the band I play with now, which is Hollis Outlanders Youth Steel Orchestra, for the past couple of years because my grandfather owns it and, well, I'd like to participate. I've also played Panorama for the past 4 years, from 2011 to 2015, played with Fun Claire. And Pan is something I've always known, so it's nothing new to me. So, anything else? My primary school teacher, they had auditions for the Pan group, so we had to go into the library and make sure that we all have timing, basically, rhythm to playing the band. And from then, she put me into the Gabrielites. I started with the double guitar, progressed to the bass, the six bass. And from the six bass, I went to the tenor, single tenor. And from the single tenor, I've been playing the double tenor for the past 5-6 years. My first panorama with Fun Clay. This was either 2011, 2012. Because it was the first time I've experienced the big stage where you play till 1 o'clock in the morning, you reach home, your body tired, but you still can't get the song out your head, you're going to sleep with your panorama song. And the best experience was the final day on the big stage, where yes, you have to pay it right, but you still have to give the performance of your lifetime. You have to jump, you have to express yourself. The greatest experience that I've ever had with Pan.
Do you remember who was the arranger of that tune? What was the name of the tune and who was the composer?
I remember the arranger, Professor. Professor Ken Fillmore. The composer. I can't remember, but
what was the name of the piece?
It's been a while, but I honestly can't remember, but it was Professor Ken Fillmore, and the greatest thing I've ever done was that panorama.
It wasn't Pan by Storm.
No, it was not Pan by Storm. I would have remembered Pan by Storm, yes.
What was the name of the band you played with now?
You know how Southlanders Youth Steel Orchestra.
And who's behind this band?
The gentleman behind this band is my grandfather. And the reason he did this was because he started playing Pan in the days where Pan was something bad. Where the only people who played Pan was the ragamuffins, people who hide in from the police, where you have to run. Those were the days he started playing Pan. So He still did it, even though he knew that when he went home, his mother was waiting outside the door for him until he come home to get his sweetest cocktail of a lifetime. It reached to the point where his sister married a Pan man, and my great-grandmother was most upset because Pan was not allowed in those days. And he thought that Pan saved his life because it was either Pan or you run with the wrong crowd. And it's because of him that he started his band, that some youths will have something to do. Instead of going with the wrong crowd, you occupy your time with something constructive. You learn music, you learn a song, and you can carry yourself with it because Pan is recognized everywhere. This is not something that only Trinidad knows. It's something you can reach far in, and that was his aim when he started his band. It started with 4 people, me and my other neighbors, 2 who are brothers and another one, and it's here to the point that there's 20 plus players. We learn different songs every week. We have people here who've been here for years. Every couple months their children would like to join us because of how we are. There are youths here, the youngest players in standard 2, and he knows 4 or 5 songs because it's something that keeps you on the right track in life. It's not something that carries you down a wrong road. In his days, apparently.
Okay, you're into tertiary studies, into poli-sci. Mm-hmm. How do you see yourself in the next 5-10 years?
I see myself graduated with at least 2nd honors, finished with my master's degree with a very good job, either within the ministry or the private sector.
Professionally,
my mentor at the moment is my best friend's father, who's Foster Cummings. He assists me in what I should do with my degree when I get it.
And in terms of your national instrument, who's your mentor?
I love, you put me on the spot there. it have to be my grandfather, because if it was not because of him, I will not be playing pan right now. I would have stopped because I lost interest in it at a certain point. But family, so when family says come help, you help. You really don't have a choice. So he said, I need your help. So it's because of him, at the moment I'm still playing pan. Wasn't for him, I would not be playing pan.
You must be a good manager. Yeah. A good manager of time. How do you mix your pan playing with your studies?
Well, it depends on how they practice. If they practice 4 days a week, I'll go 2 days a week. If they have practice 3 days a week, I'll go 1 day a week, because I still need to get my degree. School comes first, pan will come after, no matter what happens. So no matter what happens, I'll still make time for them, but I also make time for myself beforehand.
Do you stay on campus or do you travel from South daily?
I travel from South every day when I have school. Well, yes, there's a UE bus, but I also take a crib car, and then I take a Arima Maxi to UE.
You got siblings, and are they also involved in pan?
I have two younger sisters. One who was involved in pan, but due to certain circumstances, she wasn't able to come as often, because at the point in time, I was not living with her. I lived with my grandfather, so I had easy access to the band, but for her, transport from home to the band was a problem, so she never progressed in pan.
Okay. In closing, if you had to send out a message to young ladies your age, what would that mean?
Well, do what you have to do. If you like the pan and pan is something that you're interested in, stick to the pan. If you are focused, whatever you are focused on, keep your focus, because in this generation it's kind of hard to stay focused on what you want and not be sidetracked by what everybody else wants, no matter what it is. Maybe pan, volleyball, football, school, just do what you want to do in your life to carry yourself on that right track. Yeah. You're welcome.
Take care now.
Yeah.
Come. I have a secret to tell you.
A secret, let me go.
You see this list here?
Yeah.
How are you holding?
No.
No, you listen to what I tell you. You don't tell me what to do.
All right, sorry.
You listen to what I'm telling you, right? Now, you see all this weight here, and this weight here, and this weight here. I'm going to tell you something in your ears. Only I alone know. I'm going to give it the exact weight. And it's for you to look through that and tell, hello, I just talked to you.
But if my name on this,
it doesn't matter. It done on it already. Whosoever have the exact weight, I will hand you the mic, and you will tell me who it is. So I tell you in your ears, nobody here know, only me alone. Right? So yeah, I want to sit inside. I customer secret. But anyhow, you look to and find the closest seat.
Okay.
Yo.
All right. Is there Yvette wrong here? Yvette?
Yeah, nah, still in Sando.
She's still in Sando? Oh, sorry. Yvette? Cuckoo.
Yeah. Have a number?
Yes, there's a number.
Let me call it now.
Yvette, what? Wrong. Wrong here.
Yeah, what? Give me the number. Let me call it now.
Let me see, let us see. Let me
see. Let me see. Let me see. Let me see.
Let me see. Let
me see. Let me see.
Let me see. Let
me see. Let
me see. Let me see. Let me see. Let me see. Let me see. Let me
see. Let me
see. Let me see. It's not even though. No. I'm positive.
You saw that I'm not even.
No, I'm very sure. You're wrong, but it's not even though.
Yvette! Yvette! Yvette, what am I name?
I tell Yvette you win. Yvette!
Yvette!
Is that you?
Why is Christmas Day
Yvette! Yvette!
Yvette Brown, we are calling from San Fernando, the Southern Connection of Vibe City 105, to let you know that you just won the cake. Where are you from, Miss Yvette Brown? Point 410. Which part in point 410? Egypt Village, point 410. You know anybody that affiliated with the Vibe City 105 Southern Connection?
Can she call in that wrong?
Belinda, you know every blasted body?
Everybody know me.
Oh, everybody know you? All right, so Belinda, well, okay. We'll be giving Belinda this cake for you to collect.
She had to pay passage.
But she said you had to pay for transport. I can give Belinda it. I can cut piece before I give Belinda it. All right, okay, Yvette Brown. Congratulations and thanks from the Vibe City 105 for supporting us in this venture. Love, darling. Love in the house.
So many kids. So many kids.
Alright, whoops.
Only box MC. Let's see. Only box MC. What that? She put 4 pounds. 10 4 pounds. 12 pounds.
Just raise it up, let me see the plastic now.
Okay.
Get fun out. Yo.
So the landers of the Vibe City 105, going to give you a little something. Love in the house.
Thank you.
more of it?
St. Berwick's College. I play with Union Hall Steel Orchestra. I've been playing with this band for 7 years. I play the three cellos, the drums, I am the arranger. And yes.
How long have you been playing
pan? I've been playing pan for 7 years now.
Which was the first band you played with?
Union Hall South Anders. Okay. The school one I play with is St. Berwick Steel. Under Mr. DK Samai. Yeah. I've played with the band for the past 3 Sandfest competitions. Where they have won. They have came out victorious.
What year?
From 2015 to 2013.
Okay. So you tested 2 victories?
No. 3. Yeah.
What was your most memorable experience in Pan?
It's the first night I played Panorama. I put a spin for semi-finals with Skiffle Bunch. Yeah.
What tune and
who
was the arranger?
Hmm. I remember the song itself, Sapna, and the arranger. Not so much, I don't remember the arranger name. No.
So, how do you see yourself in the next 5-10 years?
Basically, just finishing university and starting my own business, and also composing music. And basically, keeping the culture alive. Not leaving the country and doing music otherwise and forgetting about our culture. So, whatever musical ability I have, I'll take it.
Are you able to translate a score?
Yes, I am able to translate a score. Yes.
Yeah. So the whole band could read music?
Oh well, right now just 2 players could read music. Right? Union or Southern Ice. Just? No, well, they learned in school. I myself learned in St. Mary's College from Miss Waters, my music teacher, and also Miss Asamai. And another student learning in Pleasantville. I'm not sure what the background about that.
So Southlanders focus on reading music, or you just play by ear?
Right now we just play by ear. Well, later on in the future we'll be teaching basically the whole band how to read music. So they won't just be coming here to play music and that is it. We'll educate them at the same time. My name is Jose Lumi. I attend St. Benedict's College. I am 18 years of age. Yes.